Ever had a con that started off like any other but turned out to be the best con of your life? It was July 2013, there were five of us covering the San Diego Comic Con. Helen O'Hara, Ali Plum, James White, Sam Toy, and me. They call me the Hewitt. Our goal was simple, to do the Golden Mile, taking in all the sights, sounds, and smells the con had to offer. Starting at the Hilton Bayfront, the Hard Rock, the Omni, the Inflatable Monsters, the 20th Ballroom, the Pretzel Stand, the Three Experiences, the Big Q, the Main Floor, the Marvel Booth, the Autograph Alley, and of course finishing up at the big one, Hall H. Are we ever gonna do it, even if it killed us?
It's the biggest comic book convention on the planet, drawing some of the biggest names in movies to San Diego every single year. It's a glorious costume cavalcade that showcases the very best in geek culture. Hello, Web. Yes, we're back at San Diego. Yes, the con is on. Welcome to the San Diego Comic Con 2013. The con began life as the Golden State Comic Con back in 1970 when it was first held here at the US Grand Hotel on Broadway and 4th. It attracted just 300 people. But now things are decidedly different. Behind me is the San Diego Convention Center, all 615,000 square feet of it. It's been home to the con since 1991 and last year played host to over 150,000 people over 4 days. Numbers it's expected to exceed this year. Now all the attendees don't have the common costume, of course, but it does help.
We think the most interesting costuming is an amalgam of things, like a cross between. So last year we were Jedi Ghostbusters, we were zombie Ghostbusters another year. So we were gonna be Ghostbusters through the ages, and we decided, why not Clint Eastwood Ghostbuster?
Yeah.
And Native American Ghostbuster.
Absolutely.
So yes, we try to make them and add to it. Like, this whole regalia was made by the Navajo Nation.
Wow.
So really? It's real cock feathers from reservation chickens, cocks, and I don't know whose tail this is, but this is all real leather and beading and stuff like that.
Yeah, and this is the replica of Clint Eastwood's actual poncho,
yes.
Just in the Ghostbusters colors.
Wow, so we could be 90% screen accurate.
Why Loki?
Well, you see, people keep telling me, hey, you look like that guy. And I figured, well, I might as well go for it and look like that guy.
Yeah. So it took you a while to get together?
It took about, I've been working on this since January. Yeah.
The ladies love a bit of Loki.
Right.
Has this proven a success with the opposite sex?
So here's what happens is you do the Loki cosplay and all the girls want to take a picture with you because they assume that I also have a crush on Tom Hiddleston and we have a common bond. That's unfortunate. I wish I had known that a few thousand dollars ago. But what are you gonna do?
Who have you come as? This is the main floor of the convention center, an astonishing assault in the senses with booths of every shape and size. It's the sort of place where you can run into pretty much, well, anyone. Oh my. When I said you can run into literally anybody at Comic-Con, I wasn't kidding. It's my old friend Jeff. Jeff! All this rigmarole is in aid of the Predator 3D Blu-ray, which is coming out later in the year. And if you buy one of 500 limited editions, you too can have your head ripped off by a Predator. Lovely. Well, the floor is awesome, but utterly exhausting, and frankly, I need some fresh air. Luckily, the convention center is no longer big enough to hold Comic-Con. It's spilled out onto the streets of San Diego over the last few years. So let's have a gander, see what's in store.
Wait, sorry. That's my bad. That's on me. I'm sorry. That's my fault. I brought him back over here. That's on me. That's right, folks. We've got a Walker right here. Come take a look at what death looks like.
Are you enjoying the con? What's the strangest thing you've seen? Where do you begin?
Last night was pretty intense here at the party. I mean, it was sponsored by Playboy, so some of the sights were absolutely extraordinary last night.
That's how my wife got me out of here last night. She put me, oh man. I got on the bungee thing, and as soon as I got off, she was like, take a shot, honey.
Jump up and out of the car park and away you go.
I'm out.
Actually, I think the strangest thing was a guy getting a parking ticket this morning, and he was dressed as the Joker, and he was really arguing with the guy, and that was just, I tried to take a photo, but it was over before it was done.
When it comes to Hollywood of San Diego, Hall H is the center of it all. Behind me, you can see the line for Hall H. Today's panels include Warner Brothers, there's a Hunger Games panel, Hugh Jackman's going to be here for the Wolverine. He's revered like a god at Comic-Con. And then the Marvel panel rounds things off at the end of the day. And all these people have been queuing up overnight, virtually, to get in. And look at their excited faces. How long have you been queuing up?
We got here at about 11?
Yeah, okay. 11 p.m. last night.
11 p.m. last night?
Yeah.
So you slept here?
Yes. Slept by like the ocean.
Way over there.
Really?
Yeah.
And then slowly moved along here. Yeah. Okay. So what are you lining up for? What's burning your
community?
Yeah, we're here for the community panel.
I'm here for a community, and it's always sunny in Philadelphia.
You've everything a Walter White aficionado could possibly want or need. So I'm guessing you're here for the community panel?
Oh, definitely. Doctor Who also.
why do you do this? Why do you come here and queue from 2 a.m.?
Because we love Supernatural.
We're really banking on everyone being here for Doctor Who.
So that when they leave, they can clear out
and then we can get up to the front.
Did you get some sleep? Did you have anything to sleep on? What did you do?
Had a quick power nap, met some great people.
Yeah. We really want to make it in, and it's fun to camp out.
An experience.
You make friends.
Yeah.
You share your food. Yeah. Someone brought Wi-Fi for everyone.
Really?
Yeah.
That must be the most popular person in the line, I imagine.
Pretty much, yeah.
Do you sleep? Do you eat? What do you do? How do you do it?
Sleep or eat or pee. It's more of a, we function as amoebas and we just sort of sit.
The Winchesters would be proud, man. They'd be proud. Great talking to all those people outside Hall H. Very excited about today's panels, especially as Doctor Who kicks things. Oh, hey, Ali, how's it going?
Good, man. What's up?
Oh, I'm just talking about the panels because, who's on first?
What's that?
Who's on first?
No, Supernatural's on first.
Who's Supernatural?
Who's a time-traveling alien?
Okay, but who's on first?
Supernatural's on first. Who's on third?
I don't know. Who's on third?
Yes.
What? First base. You get the general idea. And now for a montage of all the big names we spoke to at the Hilton Bayfront over the last few days. Who's who, if you will.
But my God, it was fun. It was just a rush. I couldn't hear anything. I couldn't see. Like, when I walked out on stage, there were so many flashes in my face. It felt like the end of Raiders of the Lost Ark, when all the Nazis are having their eyes blown out.
Yeah. Close your eyes, Tom.
I was like, close your eyes.
Don't look at it.
Open your eyes. I was like, oh my God, I can't see, I can't hear.
It's beautiful.
Yeah, exactly. Paul from, it's beautiful.
I'm well.
Also Chris.
Hi, nice to meet you.
What a coincidence.
Yeah. There you go.
This is amazing. Yeah.
That's crazy.
We're all. Are you guys related?
Don't think so.
Brothers.
Yeah. What?
No!
Dad?
You guys are brothers?
Oh, no.
What happened to your accent?
We were separated at birth. Yeah. I was raised here in the USA, and you were raised in the
by
UK.
Wolves.
Oh,
yeah.
By the wolves in the UK.
Yes.
Have you started training for Han Solo's return yet, or is that just simply picking out a new waistcoat?
What does that mean for you?
I'm not yet convinced that it's the time to talk about Star Wars.
So do you see him as a good guy at heart? I mean, because he's now manipulating so many people.
He's a patriot.
Yeah.
But you know, he understands that. You know, sometimes you got to get people to do things. He's a master manipulator. In order to manipulate people, you have to massage the truth in certain ways.
I feel very fortunate that kind of the first movie that I did coming out of the governorship was to do a cameo with Sly in Expendables.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we did it and we realized that was really fun. So he wrote a bigger part in the second Expendables. We did that and we had a terrific time. So he asked me to be back in the third Expendables. We will be doing Expendables from here to eternity. We're going to make up for the time that we lost in the 80s.
When you're looking at Godzilla on set, what are you looking at?
I'm looking at like the corner of a very tall building.
Really?
Yeah.
How can I talk about the Winter Soldier without giving anything away? You know Marvel. They're very, you know, I feel like a sniper is on me right
red
now.
Dots,
kind
of... So tell us, Chris.
So tell us. Okay, so basically, here's the deal. Here's the deal. No, I can't do it. I can't do
Amazing.
It.
Did you do this yourself?
Well,
or did you have someone do it for you?
Did this to me. Okay, I was consenting.
Luckily, the role required you to be bald at the time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a very strange sensation to have no hair. I highly recommend it for all the 25-year-old girls out there. Go and shave your heads. So I'm not alone in this.
How did Marvel persuade you to do this? Because this seems like the craziest, riskiest thing they've done yet. So do you have
you
to be...
Fire me?
Yeah. No, not that. Not that. Do you regret, in a way, not doing this in the 80s?
I do. But not for wanting, not for not wanting. It's the projects. He'll tell you. They'd say, hey, why don't you do a thing where you dress up as female cops? I go, yeah, that'll work. No one will suspect that. Or then we were a dog. He was a dog. I was a cat. So it's a metaphor. Get
it? Yeah.
Then we were bickering neighbors. I go, we're not the neighborly. It doesn't work. Maybe that's a different kind. And it just continued to roll out like that, these horrible ideas, until finally that generation went, and what was left, it goes, hey, why don't we just put you two guys in prison?
Last year I was trying not to cry. This year I was just trying not to shit myself. So I succeeded 1 year. I won't say any more than that.
Have you worked with Rocket Raccoon yet? Is he a diva?
Yes, total diva.
Yeah,
he's not here. What the hell is he not? He's not here. Why?
No, yeah. Rocket was like,
he
I'm
wanted
not
his own
out.
Plane, yeah. And he couldn't get it, and and then so he decided to stay and play difficult.
What a get!
I know.
World's End Pub Challenge. Name all 12 pubs going now. How fast can you do it?
Okay, the first post,
the Old Familiar,
the Famous Cock,
the Cross Hands,
the Trusty, no, the Good Companions,
the Trusty Servant,
the Two-Headed Dog,
the Mermaid,
the Beehive,
the King's Head,
the Hole in the Wall, the World's End.
One.
That's it.
That's pretty good. You win a prize.
Thanks, mate.
Cheers, mate. Have a good one.
Bye.
Today, at the edge of our con, at the end of our trip to San Diego, today we face the inflatable monsters that are at our door. Today we are cancelling the Videblogisode.
Really hurts the throat, that. Anyway, that's it for this year's Comic-Con. See you next year for more film-related fun. Until then, bye-bye.